time in the software. Okay. And then before even asking the person, I will do some self-verification. So I will see, okay, today is 6th, so day of Venus and also Fridays. That means Venus is really, very important.
Very important.
Then suppose I see that this Venus is linked with the career houses, which means either it is in 2nd, 6th, 10th or 11th. Then I only first ask the question to the person, do you want to know about career? Something like this. And it has happened 80 to 90% of the time the person says yes, this is the area of inquiry. Now there are events for which there could be multiple houses. Like sometimes I have seen if people come to me for a marriage prashna chart reading, then most of the time it's very surprising. I have seen the second house is involved somehow. It's very surprising. I mean, married couples, existing married, already married couples. It's very surprising. Why? Because I used to think, because seventh house is the house of the wedding or getting married, which you are already married, right? But then later on, it's a family, part of your family.
Yeah.
So the second house is very crucial that time. I mean, if somebody is not married, then the seventh house is very crucial, because the person is not married only. You know, if you don't have marriage, then what family do you have? So yeah, that is how it is to be seen. And then I check that planet. So for example, today is Friday, the day lord is Venus. I check where Venus is, which planet houses Venus is ruling. That is very important. Generally, I have seen the houses which that planet rules is the area of the question. Because that is like the agenda. The lordships show the agenda of that planet, the hidden agenda. And the placement of the planet will tell me how he or she is trying to fulfill that agenda. You know, it's like suppose India is a country, then one Indian diplomat goes to USA to do some negotiation. So he's not interested in US. He's interested in India because his main business is in India, right? So he has gone to US, but he's not going there and just sitting there. His agenda is he has to do something related to his own country, India, or any other country.
Right.
So therefore, I've seen sometimes if the planet rules seventh house and that planet is sitting in the fifth house, it means you are searching love, you know, before marriage. So your agenda is I want to get married. But then before that, what's happening? You are searching love or, you know, affection or intimacy or this kind of thing you are searching before. So now we know that, okay, the planet is ruling these houses. So this is the agenda. And the house where it is placed, he is trying to fulfill the agenda through that house. So we know the equation, how the game is happening. He wants this and he's going here to get this. So that's very clear. Then that gives us the story. But then we check the ascendant of the prashna chart.
Right.
Ascendant, not the ascendant lord, the ascendant. Mm. The ascendant will tell me, okay, he's searching all this, but what is going on in his mind basically?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So it's very weird sometimes, you know, that people are searching, like suppose Sunday somebody comes, they're asking about, so then I check Sun. Suppose Sun is in the 10th house. Okay. Great, great placement for career, name, fame, success. But then it's very weird. Sometimes then I see that Moon is sitting in the ascendant. So that means what is happening? The person is wanting to have a shift in career, but why? Because he doesn't feel good while going to the office. So Moon is a very feeling based planet. It controls emotions. So then I know why he wants to shift his company. Why he wants to go to a different place? Because he doesn't get that feel good factor when he goes to the office. Or he may search that feel-good factor because that is something which is going on in his head all the time. Oh, do I feel nice here? Are the people good? Do they treat me nicely? Moon is always very attention-seeking. So then we know, okay, the Lord is the Sun. Yes, the Sun has sent him to me, right? Because the Sun has given him the energy to see the sunrise today.
Right.
That's why he's alive. So that means that sun is very important. Then moon is in the ascendant. Now the next step is we check the ascendant lord.
Right.
So ascendant lord means the ascendant lord will tell me how much determination the person has, or how much is that question bugging him, or how much is he ready to work to make that happen.
Right.
So sometimes I see, suppose Mars is the planet, and Mars is in 10th house, or it is exalted, or in the money houses, you know, very good for finances. But then I see the Lagnesh is somewhere in debility. That is like telling there's a big opportunity which is coming to you by dint of your karma. But you are like, okay, should I take this or not? You know, I don't know. It's good, but it doesn't seem good. Yeah, on the other hand, it's opposite sometimes. You know, you the day lord is very bad place somewhere, which means you have very difficult karma coming up. But the Lagnesh is very strong. You know, Lagnesh is in Dikbal, or it's in exaltation, something like this. Then you are like, you know, no, I want to do it. I will make it happen anyways. You know, that kind of flavor will come. And I have seen if there are natural malefics in the ascendant, then the things are very difficult. Why? Because malefics in the ascendant will give you either depression or anxiety, one of the two. Like Mars, Rahu, Ketu, they can give you anxiety, hyper anxiety, you know, anger, frustration, jealousy, envy, competition, you know, these kind of things. And then Saturn will give you, you know, depression. Oh, you are not good at it. You can't do it. Leave it. You could not. Now also you cannot. You won't be able to do it ever.
Right. I want to say something here. As you rightly mentioned that in a Prashna Kundli, these three things are very important. One is the Vara, the day lord. If it is a Friday, Saturday or Sunday, the position of that Vara lord is very, very important. One thing. Second is the position of moon. Moon represents your mind, emotions, the question coming out of that, right? And the strength of the question or the area of the question is judged by the ascendant. These three things are like, it holds a great importance in our Prashna Kundli.
I will re-instantiate what I said. So first we check the day lord.
Mm-hmm.
We first check which houses the day lord is ruling.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. That will give us the agenda. Okay. Depending on your ascendant. Okay. Not moon chart, Lagna chart. Okay. Suppose the planet is ruling your seventh house, then the inquiry is about marriage sometimes. Okay.
Right.
Now the house where the day lord is placed will tell you where are you going to fulfill that agenda. So suppose the day lord rules seventh house and the seventh lord is sitting in the third. That means you are going on searching online medium, you know, like some online websites, matrimony websites.
Okay. Right.
Mm-hmm. Or if the day lord as the seventh lord is sitting in the fourth house, then some relatives from your mother's side, or maybe your mother is not agreeing to the person you want to marry, or something like this. These kind of things can happen. Or ninth lord, then the father can come. Or tenth lord, that because of career you have to stay different, separate. Okay. Then we check the ascendant. The ascendant, the first house, will tell the what is going on in the person's head.
Right.
And then we check the lord of the ascendant, because that will tell how much strength you have to, or how much willpower, I would say, not strength.
Okay.
You have to, you want to know, make that happen actually. Or how desperate you are to make that happen.
Right.
Yeah, so as I said, if sometimes the, and then also we need to check, once we understand the theme of the horoscope, then we must check, the next step is we need to check the Karakas. The Karakas are very important. So if the day lord is ruling the 10th house, we must check Mercury. Mercury is very crucial. Then Mercury can tell me, so suppose now there's a person who comes to me and says, tomorrow I have an interview. Okay. Okay, I have an interview at Google, Microsoft, and everything is done. It's only on tomorrow. Okay. So what should I do? And let us assume he comes to you on a Sunday. Let us assume like this. Then, and suppose then we see Sun, he's a Scorpio Lagna, let us assume, and he, his Sun is the 10th Lord in Scorpio Lagna. Or he comes to you on a Friday, like today, but he's Capricorn Lagna, then Venus is his 10th Lord, something like this. Okay. So then you know 10th Lord is Venus. Okay. So suppose then Venus is sitting in his third house. Okay. That third house is that interview preparation. You know, he is busy in interview preparation. Uh-huh. And then Venus is like currently Venus is in Aries. Okay. It just entered Aries. So for Capricorn Lagna, where will Venus be? In his fourth house now. Okay. So that means he is going through his school material earlier. Because 4,000 for the school, okay. And is Venus very happy there in Aries? Not so much, I guess. So that means he's panicking, he's impulsive. He wants to study everything in one night. It's like that. Okay. So then you know that, then you check the Karaka. Who is the Karaka for the 10th house? It is Mercury, of course. Then Mercury's placement. So currently what is happening? Mercury is retrograde. That definitely means that tomorrow when he will give the interview, they will ask him something which he knows, but he will not be able to say it. And then as soon as the exam is over, he will remember, this I knew, why did I not tell? In fact, the same thing has happened with one of my friends. He recently gave an exam for finance. And he was asked a question and he very confidently spoke it, which was actually wrong, actually. And after speaking, he realized, why did I say this? I spoke the opposite.
Mm-hmm.
And then the interviewer also said, oh, actually, you said the opposite. You know? And he was like, oh, yeah, yes, sir, I'm very sorry. I just spoke the opposite. You know, this is not true. The other one is true, actually.
Mm-hmm.
So now Mercury is retrograde. So therefore, some question or some comment you will make which you might regret later.
Right.
or you may try to, but then that's how Mercury retrograde is. Once it goes direct, it's all your fault. Okay. Nobody is to be blamed, only you are the culprit. So then you don't have defense, you see. So then they will say, oh, but time is up. You spoke it wrong. You ulta bola. So it's over now. Okay. Now that does not mean he will fail in the interview necessarily. But one blunder he will do, at least one.
Mm-hmm.
So that is how you see the Karaka for house and you see where Mercury is placed. So if the day lord rules the 10th house and Mercury is the Karaka. So now if Mercury is in a bad shape, then it's like saying it is... Now why is Mercury the Karaka for the 10th house? Because Mercury is the significator of skill.
Right.
So it's like saying if Mercury is badly placed in that horoscope, you will not be able to use your skill properly. And if Mercury is very well placed, then you can use your existing skills. You may not have that much skill, but whatever you have, you will use it very to the best possible capacity. And suppose, for example, the Day Lord is ruling which house? Maybe the 7th house. And then which planet you must check? You know, it is Jupiter you must check, and then you must check Venus.
Yes.
And then the next step is you have to understand what is the cultural upbringing of that person.
Right.
That is gold. If you miss that, you have missed it. Why? Because let's take 7th house for example. If somebody is in a very traditional religious background, and then you don't have to see Venus for that. If the Day Lord rules 7th house, you only have to check Jupiter. But if somebody is born in a ultra modern family where you know everything is good, ye bhi theek hai, wo bhi theek hai, sab theek hai, then why to see Jupiter? There is no custom, there is no tradition which has been followed. Do whatever you want. So then, what do I want out of the marriage? I just want the pleasure of the opposite sex or the spouse or, you know, enjoyment, food and all these things. Then just check Venus. And then I also check the lords of the trines. The trinal lords will tell you to what extent it is helping the horoscope. Yeah, and the trines are always positive. The trinal lords are always there, always benefits. And not But in general, they always help the horoscope. And if you have special planets, like if you have a planet in Digbala, you must check that. So suppose your day lord is Venus, and Venus is not having anything to do with the career houses, okay? But then if you have this Mars in 10th house, so it is like a tusk which is going on. Venus is asking about marriage, suppose, and then this Mars is, you know, pulling to the 10th house. So then you have to inform the person that, okay, my dear sir, you might get married, of course, no problem, but because of career, the pull is so much, the that your marriage may be delayed because of that. Or the thumb rule of Jyotish, if Saturn is there, then it's or if a retrograde planet is there, then second attempt is must. In first attempt, it never happens. Retrograde means at least one more attempt. Whoa, mandatory. That is mandatory. So if the day lord is only retrograde, then the challenge is more. Because then it's like saying the whole thing